Let me now turn to a foundational result in the theory of random walks known as the central limit theorem. So let's imagine thinking about a random walk in arbitrary spatial dimensions in which the single step is given by a displacement little x, and the probability distribution of these single step displacements is given by little p of little x. Let us assume that these little x's are IID variables. This is a standard acronym for independent identically distributed. So independent and identically distributed. So that is that for each x, p of x is the same distribution function. Let us further assume that the mean displacement in a single step, so we no longer have to restrict ourselves to a symmetrical random walk, let me assume that the mean displacement in a single step is finite, very mild restriction. And let me also assume that the mean square displacement in a single step is also finite. Under these conditions, then, the probability distribution after n steps, so capital P of n after n steps of the total displacements, so here big X is the sum of the displacements little x, n of these guys, then this probability distribution of the total displacement is equal to 1 over square root of 2 pi n sigma squared e to the minus x minus n times the average of little x squared divided by 2 n sigma squared, where here sigma squared is equal to the variance in the single step distribution. So it's the difference between x squared average minus x average squared. So this statement is known as a central limit theorem. And I should say that its holding in the limit is n is going to infinity. This is a very powerful and general result because one needs then only the first two moments of the single step distribution. These are the only things that matter to determine the long distance, long time properties of a random walk. So this is an example of a universal statement in which short range details of the microscopic process, namely the details of the single steps, basically do not matter in the long time limit. It doesn't matter if we're talking about a nearest neighbor random walk in one dimension or some other type of hopping distribution, as long as the distribution obeys these two conditions that the first and second moments are finite, then the distribution in the long time limit is this universal Gaussian form. So notice also that from this result, we now know that the mean displacement after n steps of a random walk, which is just the integral of x, pn of x, dx, is equal to n times the displacement after a single step. And similarly, the variance after many steps of the random walk, x squared average minus x average squared, again, using the same definition as before, so this is the integral of x squared pn of x, dx, minus x average squared, which we've already computed, this thing is simply equal to n sigma squared. So once we know the properties of the, once we know the first and second moments of the single step distribution are what they are, then we know that the distribution of a random walk of n steps is given by a Gaussian form, and from that we can compute any moment we want of the random walk itself.